listening to the Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's spine-tingling tale of the supernatural. The Strange Odyssey of Sandy Mitchell. Starring Dick Sargent. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by Dial Soap, Monroe Shock Absorbers, Camphophonique, the makers of Kodak cameras, and Breck Shampoo. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Concerns Sandy Mitchell, young, vibrant, on the verge of life. The other is Worth McClendon. He's tired of life. It has nothing left for him, except perhaps Sandy Mitchell.
Hey, Sandy, come on! Quit staring at the ocean and play!
What? Oh, okay, Stanley Ward, but don't say I didn't warn you. I'm the Billie Jean King of volleyball. My serve! Terrific. First serve, and it's in the water. I'll get it.
Hey, no fair counting that point.
Oh, Dad, help! Dad! Dad, help her! She's collapsed! Someone get a doctor! Sandy. Sandy, you awake, sweetheart?
Hi, Mom. Come on in.
Oh, Sandy. Oh, Sandy, I'm sorry. Do you hurt?
Hey, don't tear up. I'm fine. Just a little weak in the knees.
I've been with Dr. Sherman. He says you just collapsed.
Yep, plunked down like a zinc penny. All of a sudden, it was a very strange feeling.
You know, don't you?
I've always known. It's the bones, right?
The doctor doesn't say for sure, but it's serious. The test...
It's all right, Mom.
It's just that ever since your father died, things have fallen apart.
Dad died at peace with himself. I will, too, when my time comes. But you know what I want to do with the time I've got? I want to see my country.
But, Sandy, it seems better if you were to come... Okay. I know what that look means.
Boy, I never could fool you. So it's okay?
If the doctor says you can, then it's okay.
Oh, he will. I know just what he'll say. To the day.
You sound so sure. Oh, Sandy, I love you so.
Express now boarding gate 12.
Come on, Mom, hurry or I'll miss the bus.
You'll write, won't you? Tell me all the things you see.
Oh, every day. Twice when I see too much.
And come home. You'll do that, won't you? In time?
I don't know. I'll try to, Mom. I love you. Dear Mom, day 3. The country is incredible and worth the trip. Which, speaking of, I met a lovely man named Worth. Worth McClendon, a sweet, sad person who got on in Denver this afternoon.
Private to your mom, or can I see?
Well, maybe I'll give you a copy when we get to San Francisco.
San Francisco. It should be the Golden City, shouldn't it?
It can be. If it's at the end of your rainbow, Worth.
Sandy, under that girl exterior lies the heart of a philosopher.
No wonder here is just a giant hunger pang.
When we get into Salt Lake in the morning, I'll buy you a giant breakfast.
Wish, oh wish, the night would go away and part the curtain for just one more day.
Hey, that's sad. I thought you were supposed to cheer me up.
Right. Mustn't mope or be the dope. Old saying of old boyfriends.
Was he nice, or is that what you're running away from?
Oh, I'm not. I'm running, too. And what about you? What are you running from, Worth McClendon?
Fear? Tomorrow? Myself? Check one or all of the above?
Hey, look, we must really be high on the mountains. It's snowing.
Hey, Vicky, come here.
Hey, Pike, I'm trying to sleep over here.
All right, you two kids, get in your seats or I'll put you off at the next town.
Hey, driver, take it easy.
Artie, pay attention to me.
The road sure seems slippery with all the snow coming down.
No, don't be concerned. Nothing happens on these runs. The driver's probably been through 100 times.
Oh, what the hell?
Be at peace, Rick. Don't worry.
Oh, my... Look out!
Artie!
Sandy. Sandy, where are you?
Hey, mister. Help me. I'm trapped.
Sandy?
Oh, my God. Sandy!
Artie, where are you? It's so dark.
Someone, help me.
Yeah, I'm coming. Hold on.
Mister, I think I'm trapped under something.
Oh, please. Won't someone help me? Oh, God, I pay.
Oh, miss, where are you?
Leave her. I'm dying. You gotta get me out.
Just shut up, Paul. I'll get you out in a second. Miss?
Is that your hand?
Grab hold, miss. I'll try to pull you free.
I'm cold. I'm so cold.
I know. Don't worry. We'll get out of here. Sandy? Where are you?
The seat's moving. I can't move my arms.
Oh, easy, miss. I think the bus is on its top, but most of the windows are broken. I'll shove you and you wiggle out, okay?
Okay.
Try and get up near the trees.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Now, mate, come on. The fire's getting bigger.
All right, I see. Hold on. Sandy! Sandy, where are you? Artie, right? Okay. Well, let me shift the seat.
Get this old bag off me. She's dead.
Okay. Now, get out the window. Come on, move.
This way, Artie. On the riverbank up here.
Come in.
Come on, mister. You gotta get out of there. The fire's getting bigger.
Maybe this is the time, Worth. Maybe you should give up.
No, you can't.
Sandy, where were you?
I'm here now. Come on, we must get out. The fire will reach us.
What about the rest of the passengers?
All dead, including the driver. Worth, what's wrong with your leg?
Broken, I think.
Here, put your arm around my shoulder. Good. Now through the window.
Here. We're up here.
Look at all the luggage. Better grab some. We'll need the clothing.
Give us a hand up, please. Oh.
Everybody get down.
I never saw a bus blow before.
Artie, I'm scared.
So am I, Vicky. Hey, what do we do now, mister? You think anybody heard the crash?
Maybe. Although, to be truthful, I don't think so. We're miles from anything, with all this snow coming down.
You mean no one's going to come and get us?
No, I'm going to have to go for help.
You can't, Sandy. You don't even know where we are.
Yeah, it's a waste of time. By morning, somebody will come.
Or if they won't, I know.
How?
Well, the snow forecast. It'll probably close the roads.
Well, then Artie should be the one. With this leg, I'm sorry. I don't think I'd get very far.
Not me. I ain't moving from this spot.
What was that?
That's all we need. Quick. We must build a fire. Artie and Vicky, get branches, whatever's dry.
I'll get a couple of the suitcases. We'll need warm clothes. And worse, in the morning, I'll go for help.
We'll talk about it then. First, let's get a fire going.
If you're not careful, you're going to find a reason to go on living.
Yeah. Now, wouldn't that be...
I'm going now.
What? Who said he can't? Maybe help will come.
I don't think so. Anyway, wish me luck and stay off that leg. I put a temporary splint on it while you were asleep.
Well, wait.
Do you know where to head?
I think so.
Maybe I should wake Artie?
Oh, no. Better he stays quiet. He'd just get in the way. See you soon.
Be careful.
I will.
Artie, wake up.
What?
You're dreaming.
What's wrong?
Hey, let me go.
You were having bad dreams.
Oh, God, this is a bad dream. It really happened.
Yes, but Sandy's gone for help. So I want you to get some more wood for the fire.
Wood. More wood. Oh, I'm not some beast of burden.
Artie, get the wood.
All right.
What was that?
Just snow moving, I think.
Mr. McClendon, will we ever get out of here?
I think so. Sandy seemed very sure we would.
Oh!
Artie, get back here, quick!
The mountain's coming down!
Under that overhang! Artie, the overhang! Vicky, help me. I think Artie made it. We'll have to dig him out.
Where? I don't remember where.
Here, I think. Over here. Oh. Look, there's a corner of his coat. Quick, dig.
Oh, Artie. Oh, look, he's alive.
Yeah, just knocked out. Well, let's get him back to the fire.
Oh, he's going to be all right. We're going to get out. I know it now.
I think so, Vicky. I think we will.
Hello! Dear Mom, I'm trudging through the snow for 7 hours. Great fun. Glad you're not here. Love, Sandy. Hello!
Hello! Oh, anybody, can you hear me? Please don't start. You'll never hear me. Hello?
Who's there?
Where are you? Oh!
You hold on. I'm coming. Holler up so as I can find you.
Here. I fell. Over here.
Oh. What the hell are you doing out here?
Have you got a telephone? There's been a bus accident. I've got to get help.
Here as soon as I could. Where's the lady?
Here. Can we go right away?
No, miss. I'm a little bit worried about the weather and the light.
Oh, nonsense.
Satan, now you get your wily ass in the air. People might be dying out there.
I think I can show you where the bus went over. Oh, please.
Okay, come on. Hop aboard. Now, Duff, if we get them out, I'll let you know. I'll take them up to the ranger station. How many, miss?
Three.
Not here, but up on the ridge, maybe, if there's enough light.
Stay where you are. We are coming down.
What? You okay?
Sandy, yes, we're over here.
It's starting to snow again. Can they fly in snow?
I don't know, Vicky.
Sir, young lady, you okay?
Oh.
Yes, except for our friend here. He took a nasty cut on the head in an avalanche.
You think we can get him out?
I bought some blankets and food. Yes, I think we can take him out of here. There's enough light for one trip. But I'm afraid with this snow, it'll be impossible for me to get back in before morning.
Well, we can manage. As long as you can take him.
Right. Okay, come on. There's no time to waste.
I'll help you with Artie. Whereas you better get a fire going.
Sandy, thank you. You saved our lives.
You're welcome. But you better bundle up. It'll be a long night.
Hey.
Hey, Mr. McClendon. Miss, wake up. Rise and shine. We're going home.
Oh, morning.
Oh, boy. Am I glad you're here?
Where's the other girl? Where's Sandy?
Right here.
Where she was. Sandy?
Sandy?
She was right beside me when I went to sleep. Well, maybe she's trying to find some more wood.
No, I don't think so, sir.
No tracks.
I'll take the chopper up and see if I can spot her. Sandy?
Sandy!
No, damn it. I let you talk me into flying out, but I'm not leaving this ranger station without Sandy.
Sir, we're doing all we can. Seaton flew back in to bring out more of the bodies. He should have planned.
Get out of my way!
McClendon!
Well, that's Seaton.
McClendon.
Here. What the hell's going on?
I don't know. But the girl, Sandy, she's dead.
What are you talking about? She was with me last night.
Now, Seaton, you can't upset him.
Doctor, get the hell out of here or I'll beat your brains out.
Well, she can't be dead. I don't understand. We dug around in that charred bus and under some seats way in the rear with the girl.
No.
Trapped. I guess the seats protected her from the fire, but...
But what? For God's sake, go on, man.
The doctor at the crash site, he said when the bus went over the edge, she was killed. Sandy.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
The Strange Odyssey of Sandy Mitchell is an original radio drama by Keith Walker. Dick Sargent was heard as Worth McClendon. Featured in the cast were Peggy Walker, Mr. Barton, Janet Waldo, Casey Kasem, and Ben Wright. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Coolis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.